Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, I'll give you the word picture.
Okay.
I was treated as a pupil at the party train stage.
Okay.
I've had all my lessons with another instructor, so I've never met you before, yeah?
Yeah.
But I am familiar with the controls of the car. He's got a car very similar. Well, she looks exactly the same. He said today he was going to teach me how to do this. I think he called it turning the car on the road.
Okay.
By using forward and reverse gears.
Yeah.
So for this version, call me Tony.
Okay.
Are you okay with the road picture?
Yeah, you're partly trained.
Yep.
It's going to be the turning the road using forward and reverse gears.
That's it.
So it's PST3.
Yep.
You have had lessons in a car familiar with this one before,
yep.
And I'm not your regular instructor.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right, I'll leave you to meet you, Graydon.
Hi there, Tony. My name's George.
Hello, mate.
Pleased to meet you. Sorry Fred can't be with you today,
no.
But he's asked me to take your lesson for you today.
Well, he did tell me you were £10 cheaper.
£10 cheaper? No, yeah. No, only a fiver, I'm afraid. he told me today we're going to do turning in the road.
Yeah.
Using forward and reverse gears. He's filled me in. So far you've had your controls lesson, we've done moving off and stopping as well. So, a couple of questions for you, Tony. Have you done any reversing at all yet?
No.
Not done anything at all?
No.
No straight line reversing? Okay. with the turning the road, there will be some reversing involved.
Okay.
But what we'll do is we'll get to a suitable site, and I'll brief you on getting there.
Yeah.
Before we would move a car off, going forward, what routine would you do for moving off?
Just out of roll?
Yeah.
You're over-instructing here.
I was wanting to find out if you know the POM routine.
I would have learned the POM routine on moving off and stopping.
On moving off and stopping, yeah. So yeah, Fred's told me you had your moving off and stopping.
If you want to, I'm still out of roll, so I'll help you.
Okay.
If you want to ask me a question that may actually get you inside my head a bit, you could ask me a question like, have I ever done any creeping and peeping at junctions?
Okay. Have you done any creeping and peeping at junctions, Tony?
Yeah, I've done a bit of that last week.
Okay. And why did you do the creeping and peeping?
Because I couldn't see.
Okay. And how did you do the creeping and peeping?
Lean forward and coordinate the pedals so the car creeped.
Okay, so you kept the control using the pedals there. Okay. I was about to start over-instructing there. I was about to go back to POM.
Yeah, so that... that's going to be very useful today.
So that's going to be very useful today, keeping that control
yeah.
And your observations as well. If you want to keep control of the car
yeah.
when we're doing the turn in the road. Okay.
Just out of roll, there's something that you want to remember about when you teach somebody to drive, yeah?
Yeah.
You want to take them from what they already know to what they don't know.
Yeah.
You want to keep going back on what they know already, yeah?
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah? Otherwise you'd never be telling me how to do my cockpit drill, wouldn't you?
Yeah, with DHSS.
Yeah?
Yeah. I don't want to do that. Could you have done that?
Yeah.
Okay. Using the peeping and creeping, you've got your... you did that when you were pulling out. And when you were pulling out, how did you control the car, or the direction of the car?
Direction?
Yeah, what the direction the car was going in. What did you use?
I think we should get moving on here.
Yeah, moving on?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay,
if you want to get yourself set up, Tony.
You know, at a roll, how would you normally control the direction of the car? I haven't got handlebars, have I?
No, you can steering wheel.
Steering wheel, yeah.
Okay. Actually, no, because I'll fix that when we're on the road. Okay, if you want to get yourself set up, Tony,
yeah.
And we'll get to a suitable place to practice.
Yep.
Okay. Before we set off, can you tell me what you can see in your middle mirror there, please, Tony?
I can square the whole back window. I can't see very much because there's a car right behind me. I can see a bit of my head restrained and a bit of my left ear. And I can see a little bit of your head restrained.
Okay, and what can you see in your left mirror there, please, Tony?
Again, not very much, but I can see the two door handles.
Yeah.
Bit of thumbs at the car.
Okay, and what can you see in your right mirror there?
Again, bit of thumbs at the car. You'll see the top of the buildings, that red car in the middle, and the road.
Okay, brilliant. Well, if you want to start the car, and then we'll go to a place we can practice some maneuver things.
And we're going to turn left.
And we're going to turn left there, at the end of the road, please, Tony. It's nice checking your mirrors there. Has Fred spoke to you about big steering and small steering?
He's never mentioned big steering or small steering.
The pull push.
Oh, it's not steering wheels roughly about the same size.
They are the same size. Right. And turning right, please, Tony. When you're turning right here, if you can put your right hand up to the top of the steering wheel, and then pull it all the way down as we emerge out of the junction.
Okay.
And with your left, put it down to the bottom and push up. And put your left up to the top, and pull down, and right to the bottom and push up.
Is that big steering?
That's big steering.
No, it's
not.
There's no such thing as big steering.
That's pull-push steering that we use, Tony. The reason we do that is it allows you more control to keep the steering accurate, and it makes for a nicer, a smoother
steering experience. He did say steering experience. I did steer like a wuss.
Is that what he said last week?
Yeah.
That's not very nice.
Sorry?
That's not very nice of him.
No, he was in a bad mood.
Must have had a bad round of golf before he got to you then.
Yeah. No, he's giving up golf then. And turning left.
And turning left. So, how are you going to steer
right hand to the top.
But if you're going left, what hand would you put to the top?
Right hand.
If you put your left hand to the top, because you're going to pull
first. Oh, it's the opposite way.
Yeah.
Oh.
And right hand to the top, and back. Remember why I said that we do that with the steering, Tony? We don't use the pull push.
No, you didn't say.
Turn right. It gives you more accuracy over your steering. So when we turn right here,
you get more steering for the money.
You get more steering for the money. So when we turn right here, what hand are you going to put to the top?
Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. The right one.
The right hand this time. And where are you going to put your left hand? As your right hand comes to the bottom, you put your left hand down to the bottom, and you're going to push up with your left. And then when you come round, you want to straighten back up. You put your right hand to the top to pull down, and your left hand to push up.
Right hand to the top to pull down, straighten up.
Oh, sorry, I meant left hand to... Sorry, that's me getting confused there.
Sorry, you mentioned that, we'd end up in the flats, wouldn't we?
Yeah, we would have done a U-turn.
Yeah.
Like I say, we do that to keep the steering accurate, and it's a smoother steering for you as well.
So we're doing this turning the road today then?
Yes. Turning the road, it's, the aim of the turning the road is to get you from facing one direction to the other. It's a good manoeuvre to know if you're in, say, you turn into a dead-end street and you need to get the other way around. There are sometimes that you can't actually do the manoeuvre though, so you can do it on a one-way street as an example. You also, if there is any signs that say no U-turn, it's just an upside down U with a red cross, you wouldn't be able to do that. You're not allowed to do it then.
Could you do it in the main high street?
As long as it was signposted. If there wasn't a signpost prohibiting it, then yes, you could, but you probably wouldn't want to do it as the flow of traffic would be not very big. There'd be a lot of traffic, which can make it a dangerous
place. You like that word big, didn't you?
I don't like the word big. Yeah, there could be a lot of traffic, so it could be dangerous to do it then.
just the flats.
Brilliant, well done. How was that steering there? How did that feel for you?
Yeah.
So why is it you'd use the pull push like that? And turn it left here, please, Tony.
Actually, I think if we go through, they might let us into that side road.
Yeah. Sorry, Tony, I was saying about the times when you can do it, but as I was saying, it's a good manoeuvre to get yourself out from a dead end street. As an example, it's not just something you need to know for your driving test. Going to say that was you doing the manoeuvre, okay? Right, so, as I was saying, it's a way of getting yourself out of a dead end street. Now, the peeping creep that we were talking about earlier, there's three elements of, three major elements to your turn on the road. You've got your control, your accuracy and your observations. Let's turn right when we go through these signs for this turn. The control you do with the clutch, so the peeping creep that we were talking about.
Oh, just the clutch?
It's balancing the clutch and your gas. And also the brake if needs be as well. Because on the road you've got a thing called the camber, which is the road sits at an angle like that. So
and turning right.
Turning right, please. So sometimes you wouldn't be using the gas, you would be using the brake because you'll have the gravity of the road. Or the gravity of the camber will move your car. The accuracy is down to your steering. And the observations always need to be effective and all round to make sure that we do the manoeuvre safely, or that you do the manoeuvre safely.
Help me with that,
wouldn't you? Sorry, Tony?
You'll help me with that, wouldn't you?
Yes, I'll help you with that. Because, as you said as well, you've not done any reverse. Because there is some reversing involved in the manoeuvre as well, so I'm aware this is the first time you'll be reversing. It's got a lot of roadworks on today. Enjoying your lessons with Fred then?
Yeah. He doesn't get me lost like you did, huh?
No. Can you remember what the three elements were I spoke about in turning the road there? I thought.
Left of the lights.
And left of the lights, please, Tony.
No, sorry.
There was the first thing was the control, which was your clutch, gas and your brake, to control your speed. The accuracy was down to your steering, and your steering's doing very well around the corners here. And then your observations, which we'll be looking all around just to make sure it's safe when we do the manoeuvre.
turn left.
I'm going to turn left, please, Tony. That was a really good clutch there. Well done. Good observations as well. Well done.
Kind of a suitable ride, yeah.
Okay, so this is a suitable area. We're going to practice the manoeuvre, Tony. Okay. Can you remember when I said about you wouldn't do the manoeuvre at all?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. And obviously the time that that it's handy for us to do that was the camber that I mentioned about there. Okay.
What's a camber?
The camber is the curve in the road.
But they put that in to make this manoeuvre difficult, did they?
Well, the road is cambered, the reason our road is cambered is actually for drainage.
Oh, okay.
But this here is where we're going to use the control element
yeah.
for the car, okay? So we're going to start off in this position here.
Yep.
Okay? And then we're going to use the palm routine as we move off. Okay? Obviously you've been using the palm routine already from your previous lessons. Excuse me. So as we move off, we do our observations.
As we move off.
As we move off. We do our observations all round. So the same as when we're moving. But what we're going to do is we're going to go from this kerb and we're going to use the steering to take the car over to the opposite kerb. Yeah? At this point here, we're then going to we're going to secure the vehicle by putting the car in so yeah, we're gonna move over to the other kerb. Now we're gonna judge this, or you're gonna judge it by the kerb. And we're gonna use this as a reference point, or you're gonna use this as a reference point.
It's showing two reference points there.
It's showing two reference points. So when you get the first reference point here,
yeah.
What we're gonna do is we're then gonna move the car forward.
What's that reference point for?
That reference point is for your first stop. It's for your steering, because what we're going to do here, I keep saying V. What you're going to do here is you're going to then move the car forward slowly.
Yeah, what's the reference point for?
This is when you're going to put the steering wheel the other way.
Okay.
So you're going to put the opposite turn on the steering wheel. So we're going to move the car, you're going to move the car forward about this distance here.
The length of that?
The length of this.
Yeah.
Okay. So very slowly, moving the car forward this length. And that will then give you the second reference point that you can see here. And whilst doing that, you're going to turn the steering wheel in the opposite direction.
Okay. What's the second reference point for?
The second reference point is so that we don't hit the curb. Because you don't want the front wheels to hit the curb. Okay.
Can you try doing a little bit more of this on your own?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Once you've got that second reference point, but then you're going to put the car into reverse. Okay. The palm routine again. So you're going to do your observations all round, and moving the car into reverse. Doing your observations, and again we've got a first reference point and a second reference point. So when you get to the first reference point, which is your first reference point here. When you've got the kerb coming into your rear window over there, You've got it there. Again, we're going to stop. You're going to stop. You're then going to reverse back this distance and at the same time turning the wheel in the opposite direction. Okay? That means the car's now in this position. Again, we're going to do, you're going to do the palm routine.
Or second reference point, right?
The second reference point is so that we don't hit the curb. It's important that we don't hit the curb for safety.
Just what I asked, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's just what we asked. And we move off. Again, your palm routine, so your observations as you move off, facing the opposite direction, and then straightening the steering wheel to move off. Have you got any questions about that at all, Phil?
Yeah.
Okay. If you if you want to start the engine again then, and we'll...
It's a bit distracting having that book reflecting on my
eyes. Yes, it will be. Okay. I'll pop that down here for you. So what's the first thing you're going to do, Tony?
Get ready.
Okay. Actually, can I get you to put the clutch down with the thickness for a pound
clutch
coin?
Clutch down.
The clutch down thickness for a pound coin.
Clutch juice down.
Come off the gas, please, Tony.
All the way?
All the way, please. The control that I was talking about earlier with the pedals, we want to balance the clutch and the gas.
I haven't touched the clutch yet. I've got it all the way down.
Okay.
Can I put a gas pack on there?
You want to find the biting point first. Sorry, Tony. I'm getting myself in a muddle.
Just out of roll, why don't you take one fault at a time, yeah?
Yeah.
What was I doing with the gas?
You had the gas all the way, not all the way down, but you were getting there.
Yeah, so could you not have just said to me, ease off the gas, thickness of a pound coin?
Yeah.
Right.
So, ease off the gas, the thickness of a pound coin, please, Tony. Okay, you can bring the clutch up to the biting point. Come off the gas again, please, Tony.
Think about the word why.
Okay. if we have too much gas on, we're going to lose control and the car's going to go too fast. The wheels will actually spin and you'll start skidding.
Oh, the car, it doesn't move till you bring the clutch up, does it?
It doesn't. And obviously your clutch is all the way down. But when you bring the clutch up to the biting point, if you've got too much gas, the car's then going to jump forward and you lose control.
So the biting point now, yeah?
Yeah, but if you could still come off the gas, thickness of a pound coin.
I have.
Can you come off another pound coin again, please? And again, please, Tony. Okay, and yet now you can find the biting point. We need to release the handbrake. Can you put the clutch down the thickness for a pound coin, please, Tony? The car was moving forward there when we weren't ready to move. And that's because we were up too high on the biting point.
Would that affect it when I let the handbrake down?
It will. When you put the handbrake down, the car's going to jump forward. And again, that's us losing control. Okay? So we've got your feet locked in to that position.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
So you can get the handbrake ready to go off. And then we do our observation. So we need to look all the way left, right over to the blind spot, over my shoulder. We're checking all the way around and the mirrors as well, including your. Sorry, Tony. Let me rephrase that. You need to check your middle mirror first, because that gives you your true picture of what's behind you. And then we're going to check over my left shoulder, all the way around into the blind spots, scanning, and then all the way around to the right, including your right blind spot, like all the way over to that garden fence there, just checking there's nobody there.
Okay, yeah.
And then you're going to move forward slowly, using the creep, remember from the creep and peep, and turning
quickly. It's going really fast.
Cover the brake. Stop, Tony.
Stop.
Yeah, you have. Okay. Oh, totally fucked.
I've stopped.
I messed it.
Come on.
Sorry. Okay. Can you see the curb in your mirror? Sorry, where is the curb Where is the kerb cutting into the car at the
just
moment?
Just ahead of the door mirror.
Just ahead of the door mirror, okay. So, you've still got the brake covered, which is good. We need to move forward this distance and turning the wheel in the opposite direction as quickly as we can, but whilst the car's moving this distance, we need to be moving the car first whilst we do it. So, because we've actually, we're facing downhill.
I can turn the wheel here.
But we need to do it whilst we're moving, or else you get dry steering, which damages the steering mechanism. Okay, so if you want to come off the brake gently, think this for a pound coin.
All the way off.
If you keep the brake covered.
So in other words, release it completely.
Release it completely. Okay, and stop there. So where's the kerb now coming into your...
Looks like the door mirror is just on the curb.
Okay. Okay. So we can now put the car into reverse. Actually,
what's that reference point for?
So you don't hit the curb. That reference point is there, so you don't go forward too much and hit the curb.
Why?
Because it'd be dangerous if you hit the curb. You could hit any pedestrians. You could cause damage to the car.
I've never done this before, you know, didn't you?
Yeah. You could damage the car, you could hit a pedestrian. Now we want to get the car into reverse. So you've got the clutch down, so we need to select reverse because that's the direction that we want the car to move into. To select reverse in this car, if you put it into neutral, now there's a collar. If you put it back into neutral again, Tony, there's a collar underneath that you need to lift up and hold up.
I think you're getting really sore.
Do you want to put the handbrake on so I can secure the car? To get reverse, you lift the collar. Now that says in sick tonight, Tony. So I need to put the car back into neutral, please. We need the car to be in reverse, because that's the direction.
That'll roll.
Yeah.
Let's get a big bit of paper. Right, in great big letters, WHY.
Yeah.
And we'll stick it on the dashboard in front of you.
Yeah? I'll do that.
No, that was a joke. Yeah? I'm oh, sorry, are you not watching me anymore?
I was aware it was a car. Yeah. Okay. We need the car to be in reverse because that's the direction that the car's got to go in. And if you're not in reverse, the car will go forward. And that's not the direction we want to go in, that's dangerous, we'll then hit the curb.
Why is it dangerous?
Well, if there's a pedestrian on the curb, we could then hit that pedestrian.
Yeah, I'll see the pedestrian.
Okay. You could also cause damage to the car if you hit the curb as well.
There's no logic to this, is there?
No.
When I'm going backwards, where am I going to be looking?
You're going to be looking through the back window.
So the danger is, because I'm going to be looking out the back window.
Yeah. So the danger is, you're going to be looking out the back window, but if you're not in the right gear, that's not the direction the car's going to be going in. You need to be looking in the direction.
The right gear.
The correct gear.
Which is?
Reverse.
Oh.
So that's why the car has to be in reverse, Tony.
Well, I think I remember. I've done it once before. All the controls are this in. Oh, yeah, I got it.
That's it? Brilliant. Okay. So you can prepare to move off.
Yeah.
And you need to get the handbrake again, Tony. So we need to do the observations again before we move off. Which is all the way to your right side.
Yeah.
Okay. And scanning all the way around to the left.
Yeah, what am I looking for?
You're looking for any pedestrians, vehicles?
Nope, yeah. Moving.
Yeah, you need to look all the way around, Tony.
All the way around where?
All the way around to the front.
Yeah.
And over my left shoulder as well.
Over your left shoulder?
Yep. Because we're still looking for any blind spots.
Is it not easy to look over mine?
Sorry, over your left shoulder.
My head won't stretch that far.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. Okay, and then releasing the handbrake, and then balancing the clutch and accelerator, and then looking all the way around, including through the back window as well, Tony.
Do I keep looking this way?
You want to look over that way as well, because your picture can change at any time. Oh, right. You want to get that first reference point with the curb cutting in.
It's gone really fast.
Okay, so you can cover the brake, Tony. Squeeze the brake.
I squeezed it.
Okay. So if you keep...
I squeezed it.
Okay. So now we need to
How do I know when to stop?
You've got the curb cutting into the mirror. Not the mirror.
Oh, you tell me where the reference points are, do you?
No, you find the reference point. Where is the curb cutting into the door?
You just put in a smoking sticker.
Okay, so you now need to reverse back this distance.
Yeah.
And stop before you hit the curb, which... So no more than this distance, turning the wheel in the opposite direction.
How do I know when to stop?
You use the...
Fred normally teaches me things before he asks me to do them.
It's the curb cutting into the...
Could you tell me when to stop?
Yeah, I could tell you when to stop. Yeah, I could. I will tell you when to stop.
Nice, what do you want me to do?
So I want you to move the car back this distance, but I'm going to tell you when to stop, and as you're moving slowly...
I'll keep my eye on that 220 sign on that door, yeah?
Turn the wheel the other way and looking all round for all observation. Round. Yep, including through the back window as well. Oh. Okay.
How do I move?
You need to come off the brake.
All the way?
All the way. And you need to turn the wheel the opposite direction. Okay, that'll do, Tony. And now you can select first gear.
How will I know when to stop the next time?
Where's the curb cutting into the car now, Tony?
Just in the corner of that window.
And that's important to know that so that we don't hit the curb. So if you select first gear. And then before we move off, again, checking all round for your blind spot.
I check first, do I?
Yeah. So
I'm not doing plumb anymore.
Yeah?
Oh, prepare first, yeah?
Prepare first, yeah.
Yeah, alright. Yeah.
Okay. And then observing all the way around.
Just there?
No,
there.
No. Where? Not all the way around, including the blind spot over your right shoulder.
I don't look behind me. Which is a man and a dog walk behind me. Cause
yeah, give me
that. Because my clutch control is not great, is it?
My instruction's not good. Yeah, so...
Out of roll,
yeah.
I pay more attention to me than you are to those cars, yeah?
Yeah.
They have got room to go past us, yeah?
Yeah.
Right?
Okay. Yeah, so you're looking over your left shoulder.
Yeah.
Scanning all the way around.
Do I look at them?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Scanning through the front window.
Yeah.
And over to your right shoulder as well. Okay, and then when it's safe to move off, move off. Keep turning the wheel round. Sorry, I let my self get flustered with those cars.
Yeah, can you just explain to me what POM means?
Prepare.
You banged on about the back of the tips then, do you?
Prepare observation manoeuvre.
So how come you're asking me to use it, but you're not using it yourself? You mixed it all up there, didn't you?
Yeah, I did.
What were you doing?
I was getting you to observe before you did your prepare.
No, I didn't know. I never looked around me. But somebody was looking around, though, wasn't they?
Yeah.
Why do you reckon that black car didn't go around us? Think of eye contact. Did you make eye contact with that black car?
No.
Yes, you did.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yes, I kept looking.
Yeah. And what does she think you were probably going to tell me to do?
She would have expected me to tell you to stop and then...
No, I think because you were looking at her, she was expecting me to move. If I never looked at her and you never looked at her, I bet my bottom dollar she'd have gone past us.
Yeah.
Who's paying you for this lesson?
They shouldn't have.
Sorry?
They shouldn't have.
Yeah. So can I have a bit more attention, please?
Yeah.
If you want to take the registration on with the American, we'll give her a ring later on, yeah?
Okay.
Yeah, it's no good banging on about POM, and you're not doing it yourself, yeah?
Yeah.
Because you caused the chaos there, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Sorry, Tony.
Right, I'll just... get to a point where we can do it again.
Okay.
Do you understand the word widen?
Yeah. It's about the reasons why we do what we do.
So why are you not using it?
It's the point of educating, isn't it? It's to know the why.
Good the way I held back.
That was good the way you held back there, and also your peeping and creeping, which is the controlling the car, and good observations. Checking to see before you do a manoeuvre.
Okay, so we've had one go.
Yeah.
Can I try it again?
Yeah, let's try it again.
Is there anything you want to ask me?
Yeah, so, before we move off, what are you going to do, Tony?
No, is there anything you want to ask me?
Is this in roll or out of roll?
Have you put any money in the bike?
I've only done one brief, so no, I don't have money in the bank.
Have we just done one turn in the red?
We've just done one. I would want to ask you what...
How much help do you want from me, Tony?
How much help would you like from me, Tony?
I'm probably going to need quite a lot, because that last one didn't feel very good.
Okay.
I had people tooting the horns at me, and I don't know what went wrong, but it didn't go very well.
Okay. So you've asked for help. Can you remember how you set the car up to go to start the manoeuvre?
Yeah, okay. No problem with that bit, didn't I?
No, you were fine with that bit.
Well, I really struggled when I got to the other side of the road.
Okay.
I thought I was going to end up in the living room watching Jeremy Carl.
Okay. Would you like...
What caused that, I wonder?
That was because I didn't explain it to you and I got flustered because the car's round about.
Yeah, in English, so I can understand it. Maybe I should have pulled a handbrake up halfway across to slow the car down.
No. When you get over the other side of the road, there was the camber that I was talking about. Gravity then takes over the moving of the car.
Yeah.
So to keep the control, move your foot from the gas to cover the brake, and we squeeze the brake the thickness of a pound coin.
Oh, right.
To keep the control.
Oh, right.
Let's try that. So where are you going to look around, Tony, before we move?
I think I can remember that bit. I look in the mirrors and I become... I look around me. I take on looking for pedestrians.
Yes.
I'm walking down the pavement. Look ahead. Nobody coming. Don't look in that mirror.
Yes, you do as well.
He's come over here, be gone. Oh, I got to look over that blind spot, haven't I?
Yeah. And why are you looking over there?
Because it's time to see what's coming. Car's coming. Can I go now or do I have to repeat the observations?
For the time that's now passed.
That's a straightforward question.
Yes, you do.
Go now?
Yes, you can.
Where's that? Just go straight into it, yeah?
No. No, because you've got to do your observation again before.
Oh, right. Yeah. Is that what you meant by effective observation?
Effective observation, yes. Right. That's what I meant by effective observation, Tony.
I've got to be effective again, haven't I?
Yeah, always got to be effective, Tony.
Turn the brake on.
So now if you come off the gas, cover the brake, squeeze the brake.
Shall I just stop here for a minute? Or is it okay to keep going while they're walking past?
No, let them go past. Oh.
So
cover the brake, yeah. Squeeze it.
I've got to stop at a certain point, haven't I?
Yeah, so you want the kerb...
Oh yeah, I know where it is now, yeah. Okay. I'll stop there, didn't I?
It is. So now we want to move forward this distance, Tony.
Yeah.
And turning the wheel.
I'm just trying to remember what that first reference point was for.
Okay.
Oh yeah, that's where I take the steering off.
That's right.
Take it off now, don't I?
Yeah. Moving forward slowly so that we don't do dry steering.
Oh, dry steering.
Damage
the
car.
Yeah. What does dry steering do again?
It damages
the car, doesn't it?
Yeah, you know that. I should ask you that.
To stop at that second reference point. Oh, that's where it was the last time.
Okay, and why do you have that second reference point?
So I don't mount the curb.
Okay.
And kill pedestrians. I've got to get prepared, haven't I?
Yeah.
I know where reverse is this time. It's important to get reverse, isn't it?
Yes. Why is it important to get reverse, Tony?
I don't want to hit that wall or pedestrians while I'm looking that way.
Okay, and what way are you going to be looking?
Around there.
Yeah.
Down the road. On the pavement. Oh, behind me.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm turning the wheel. At a certain point, do I look over the right shoulder?
I was going to say, yeah, when should you do that?
I'm not sure.
Okay, you could do it now.
Yeah, but how do I know in future? My body feels like it's about halfway across the road.
Once you're halfway across the road. Right. And you're looking for that first reference point.
Well, I'll do it the pedals again.
You cover the brake.
I'll cover the brake, yeah.
Do you remember why you're looking for that first reference point?
Oh, yeah, it's there.
Okay.
That's where I take the steering off.
Yep.
But I have to do it when I'm moving.
That's correct. Do you need to do it when you're moving?
Do I need to be effective again?
Yes, you do.
Oh, yeah, sorry, I'm damaging the steering mechanism.
Okay. Have you got that second reference point?
Yeah.
And why did you need that second reference?
So I don't mount the curb.
Okay.
And hit pedestrians. Okay. Ready? I've got to do effective, haven't I?
That's right. If why do you need to make it effective?
I don't, because I might roll back. They're moving, so I won't move. Let me go.
Okay.
No, he's not.
He's not.
Yes, he is. No, he's not. Yes, he is. No, he's not.
Good observations there, Tony. Well done.
That would drive on the turn left.
Okay. How did that feel on the second one for you there, Tony?
A little bit less confusing than the first one.
Yeah? And why did the observations need to be effective on it? When you were doing your scanning round?
I killed people. Oh, Georgie boy, how did that feel?
I was about to swear, I forgot the camera's on. Poor on my part.
Yeah, it looked like you'd never done it before.
Yeah, and I have done it before.
Yeah. How much studying are you doing?
I'm studying. I know I've not seen you for a couple of weeks, but I've even got notes of studies and stuff that I've been doing.
Well, you've been doing 2 minutes here and...
No,
I'm watching Coronation Street.
Sat down, put my headphones on.
Right?
I did put my headphones on, but yeah, I'm not doing it right.
Well, you want me to do, you know, you made, you know, you were going to instruct me on POM at the test centre, yeah?
Yeah, I was.
Well, you want to start doing instructing yourself on POM, innit?
Yeah.
Yeah? Because I think I know POM better than you, don't I?
Yeah.
Yeah? You caused chaos on that first one, yeah?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah? Okay, we had a few tutor horns on that one. I didn't worry about it.
Yeah.
Yeah? Yeah, on that first one, you actually caused chaos, yeah?
Yeah, I did.
We had caught a good road there. That black mare could have got past us, no problem. Yeah?
Yeah.
But she was worried about going, and so would I be, if I saw the instructor who... Because most people think the instructor is in charge of the car, yeah?
Yeah.
If I saw the instructor keep looking round, I'd be a bit worried about trying to go past him, yeah?
Yeah.
We just saw it there with the green Corsa. He's letting me go. He's not letting me go. He's letting me go. He's not letting me go, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, you need to watch this video back.
Yeah.
Yeah? And you need to look at... Where one needs to pull one's finger out, as the Queen would say, yeah?
Yes.
Well, I'll give that a pause.
Okay.
You got any paracetamol?
No, I don't, but I might buy some.
Not for you, for me.